everyone who comes and goes in a car is contributing to traffic. What we have to do is figure out a way to incentivize people to condense their travel. And we hope the new tram system is the first step. And we believe that it will be if we can implement it the way we envision it happening. Some other ideas that we are talking about is a new resort amenity fee structure. Rather than make it restrictive, we feel like we should make it open to all guests. Because after all, if someone comes down from Tennessee and they rent a unit through Resort Quest, when they go home, their experience is Sandestin. It's not Resort Quest. They may not even remember who they rented from if they rented through the internet. But they will remember their experience here, and if it wasn't as pleasant as it could be because we don't make the resort available to them, then I think it's a mistake for all of us. If Sandestin Investments is going to have a successful rental program, it should be because we earned the right to represent the owners who want to put their units in it, not because we hold back access to the rest of the amenities within the resort. And I'm willing to gamble that we can do that. I'm willing to gamble that we can provide a better service and better return, and that we will eventually own the confidence of the majority of the owners. I'm not here to take a pot shot at anybody, but I'm going to give you an example of the difference in a unit that is rented through an organization and one that is rented by a private owner. And you're all probably familiar with VRBOs. It's one method. The difference is control of the property. If you mail the key away to an owner's guest through a VRBO connection, there's no one on site to monitor that guest. There's no one on site that is responsible for their behavior within the building. And so even though it's the right of the owner to rent, they're renting a unit that may be in a complex that has a number of other units, owners there, and that occupancy affects them all. So we want to work with everyone in order to come up with a better plan. Some of the other topics of discussion today within our group are how to improve the experience aside from the amenity program and aside from the sun and the golf. My wife and I are avid walkers. Some of you will probably see us every morning out for a walk throughout the resort. And one of the things that was apparent to me pretty quickly is it's a beautiful place to walk. There's a lot of wildlife, particularly early in the morning. It's quiet. But I noticed after a few days that I was missing something, and that was the sensory experience of flowers and aromas coming from new blossoms on the trees. As Kent said, we just moved into Sandestin, and part of our move was to enhance the landscaping in the house we bought, and so I had my landscaper go on a mission to Central Florida to buy citrus trees and fruit trees. And he called me, and he was all excited. He said there was a nursery down there that had a substantial number of mature trees that they had not been able to sell because of the recession. And he said, Tom, they've got some gorgeous trees down here, and they're really looking to make a deal on them. And it sparked a thought, and I said, you know, I want them in my yard. Why not in the resort? So I mentioned to Dave Stowe that I would like for the SOA to entertain an idea that may or may not appeal to everyone, but I think it's something of interest. And that would be to buy 100 or 200 citrus and fruit trees and plant them all along the sidewalks in the walk areas under the beach in front of Inspiration one morning, and we saw a fresh deer track. There were raccoon tracks and even a bobcat track on the beach. And I am a very avid outdoorsman, and I thought about a couple of places we've been recently, like Saddleback and Phoenix, Arizona, where wild quail circulate throughout the resort. And I called a friend of mine who is in the quail hunting business and asked him what it would take to introduce quail to Sandestin. And he had his plantation manager put together a program, and he sent it to me, and we'd like to talk about introducing maybe 15 or 20 covey of quail throughout the resort this fall. so that you get a chance to enjoy these delightful birds. They are not destructive. They do not harm the planted vegetation. They don't roost on cars. And they're just an attractive little species to be able to see and share the resort with. We've come out with a new rental program fee structure. And I've heard twice in the last week that people have been misinformed about it. The current proposed split is 65-35. The owner gets the 65, we keep the 35, which is more traditional in this industry. We've seen a couple of emails and heard some comments that people are saying it's the other way around. And so I just thought I'd mention that in passing. There are a number of other smaller issues that I think will probably get our attention. Some will come from you today in the question and answer period, I'm certain. We know we have some deferred maintenance in some areas. We've already started addressing those, and we will work through them as quickly as we can. The village is important. The village is here, and it's going to be here pretty much forever. Our goal is to make the village a family, entertainment, shopping area that not only will create a good experience for the owners and the guests, but will allow the merchants to be successful. And we're taking some steps to do that. It's probably premature to go into detail, but we're going to work very closely with them to try to make it a much more enjoyable, more diverse retail component of the resort. Access has already been addressed by Kent. I will tell you that so far, our experience with these merchants has been very good. They're open to ideas and to change, and they know they have to be a part of any solution that will come about. And I think parking and issues around the village can be worked out on a reasonable basis. I think part of the overall goal is not only to control access, but to make it more user-friendly. And we're looking at the parking lots that we did inherit and trying to figure out how to make them more beneficial to everyone. It doesn't work very well the way it is. They fill up too quickly, they fill up sometime with the wrong cars, and they are not well controlled. So we're looking at those issues, and I think we have some ideas that we'll be able to present to you on that in the near future. I will tell you that the long drawn out due diligence process, which actually started a year ago this past November. So it was an 18-month due diligence negotiation and closing cycle. While very tedious and very, tiresome and frustrating at times, did give us an opportunity to explore the resort in much more detail than we would have on a much shorter cycle. I think we know the resort pretty well from being on the outside. I am now on the inside, and I've already learned a few things from just living here, and I'm sure that there will be more things come to light as time goes on and as we get into the first summer season. We've been in Destin now 11 years. I lived at Silver Shells from the time that we started developing it until about 2.5 weeks ago when we moved into Sandestin. I believe in hands-on development. I believe that you have to be accessible to people. We won't always agree, but a disagreement doesn't have to lead to a confrontation or litigation. We should be able to sit down, discuss the issues, and come to a resolution. You won't like all the decisions I make, and I probably won't appreciate your position all the time, but I'll hear it, and I'll tell you why I'm where I am, and hopefully there's some common ground.